to Mara Simon Hoffs, who brought the task upon herself to bring Joseph O'Connor's stage play Red Roses and Petrol to the big screen. Olivia, having seen the play in New York, how did you first get involved in Red Roses and Petrol? Had you seen the play before, or?
You know, I had not seen the play, Sean. It was on in New York, I know, at the Irish Arts Centre, but I never got to see it because I wasn't in New York at the time. But the Celtic Arts Centre in Los Angeles, in Studio City, I got a call from them to say that Tamara Simon Hoffs, and she was having a reading of this Irish movie script, and she was looking for, you know, a woman to play the lead role in it, and ideally she was hoping to get like the real deal, the real Irish person.
Nice.
So anyway, you know, here's her number, give her a call. I called Tammy, and of course it turns out I thought it was going to be like a 5-minute phone call, and where are you doing the reading, and sure, I'd be delighted to help you out, and let's just go and meet up.
Right.
An hour and a half later, the pair of us were still on the phone. Turned out we were neighbours. She literally lived 2 blocks from where I lived.
Oh, that's amazing.
So by the time we were finished with our phone call, it's like, well, listen, don't bother sending it to me. I'll just walk over and pick it up from you around the corner.
Right.
So that was it. The minute I spoke to her and the minute I met her, I liked Tammy.
I love you, Ma. Do you know that?
I know you do.
Dad loved you as well. He told me.
He told you that?
Yeah. Night-night.
First of all, I think it's a situation, and it's not so much the way it is today, but in the past, I think when a married couple in Ireland are married, that's just it, for better or for worse, and that's very much the way it was back then. It's not like that anymore. Now it's like divorce is there and people have choices and they either choose to move on or they don't. But I think in with Moya Doyle, she marries Enda and that's it, for better or for worse. And she really loves him, but he's just not very good at expressing his love to her.
Right.
Which is also, I think, a very Irish thing. We're not always the best at saying I love you, whereas you hear Americans at it all the time. They'll be on the phone to their mother and be like, okay, love you, gotta go, bye. We don't really express that so much in Ireland. Well, that's my experience of it anyway. I don't mean to generalize, but that's not to say we don't feel it and that we're not there for our loved ones when they need us.
You'll see when you're married, you think it's that warm, romantic feeling inside. There's a lot more to it than that.
So, what is it, Mrs. Doyle?
It's hard to say, Tom. It just is.
Organically it happened because I found when I was, you know, delivering the lines, I was delivering these lines the way my mother would say it. And I think it just happened naturally. I didn't sort of sit down and say, okay, I'm going to do this person like my mother. It was just like, that is just what happened when I was, even when I was studying the script on my own, I found that when I was like reading the lines out loud to myself, I was saying them the way my mother would say them.